Frank, is there's nothing really like us at Cornell. Because ultimately, a lot of engineers, you know, like, this isn't always their interest. You know, their stereotype is the stereotype for a reason. You know, like, they don't want to go out. They don't want to talk to the client. They don't want to do any of these things, right? They don't want to build the empathy. They want to build solely the device. And so what we're going to do is just to change that. Kind of break the chain of what it means to be an engineer. Kind of show the world that, you know, being an engineer is more than creating the technical thing, but also moving forward and pushing it across. So I think that's really what we aim to bring towards Cornell engineers.
What we try to do is kind of design and build medical devices that are low cost for developing countries. Typically gear our projects towards typically unaddressed problems that either don't have enough resources to have like a high demand by like large companies to kind of solve those problems, or they're kind of niche problems that you wouldn't normally think about.
We're also building devices that could potentially help people in developing countries, help improve healthcare infrastructure, and make an actual difference in the world, which is something that really excites me and motivates me when I go to work on a project.
I want to do engineering, but I also want to have my time here at Cornell have a very direct impact on, you know, people, and more than just, you know, build something that's maybe, say, very high tech and, you know, it looks very fancy, but instead of just doing that, why don't we do something that we can say, here, we can put it out in the real world, and this is something someone can actually use, and this is something that someone actually needs.
First, we made a vaccine refrigeration device. Medical brigades have to go out and kind of distribute vaccines. The problem is that the coolers they use, oftentimes the vaccines spoil on the way to those villages. So what we decided to do is make kind of a cooling device that uses no electricity but can passively cool vaccines up to 16 hours. So
taking our team to Peru is going to be a really excellent experience for us because it's going to allow us to interact directly with doctors and healthcare providers on the ground and ask them for direct feedback on prototypes that we're planning on bringing with us. We're going to be able to hold up our prototype and they'll be able to give us feedback about how comfortable it is to hold in their hands, or maybe cultural acceptance. Maybe the color is simply wrong and people don't like that color or don't associate that color with medicine.
We want to be on the ground because we need to know what their needs are. And there's really no way that we can find what their needs are unless we talk to them in person. There's only so much that Google can tell you. You know, all of that's through some kind of a filter.
I personally, like, with this crowdfunding opportunity, I would never have thought that we would even have the opportunity to kind of, as an entire team, kind of go to and volunteer together and have an experience like this.
We are a small project team, so really, like, we do struggle financially in a lot of different ways. Like, we have big goals, we have, you know, lofty
dreams
that we're really trying to hit.
The reason that we really, really need external funding to go to Peru is that we're a very new project team, and we're a project team in a field that's not particularly profitable. So while other project teams don't have that hard of a time finding industry sponsors, they'll sponsor their team because then they expect to bring all of those students directly into their company. We're trying to make very low-cost medical devices that aren't really going to make a huge amount of money for anyone.
Thank you so much for listening to this long video. I know your eyes are starting to droop towards the end of this video, but ultimately, we would love if you guys can do anything to really help our team out. You know, we have a lot of fun and really like you to join us and really be part of our greater network and our greater group.
Thank you so much for your interest in our project team, and we would hugely appreciate any donation that you could give us to help us achieve our mission of bringing our team members to Peru.
thanks for your donations. It means a lot.